Hello, I'm Dr. Lakshmi Satish, practicing ENT surgeon at Skin Cosmetic and ENT Care Center and visiting consultant at Sagar Hospital and XL Care Hospitals, Bangalore. Generally, the foul-smelling ear discharge, the commonest reason is a condition called cholesteatoma. Cholesteatoma is equal to skin in the wrong place in the middle ear, leading to local destruction of the tissues and a foul-smelling ear discharge. Sometimes it can also happen due to a neglected, left-alone, old foreign body such as a cotton ball in the ear, which is secondarily infected. So, coming to cholesteatoma, this is the commonest cause for a foul-smelling ear discharge. It happens in a condition called unsafe type of CSOM. CSOM is chronic suppurative otitis media. Here there's a defect in the tympanic membrane in the attic upper part or in the corner called a posterior marginal perforation, and the dead skin keeps growing inwards in the form of a socket, and all the dead skin and the keratin accumulates, which is secondarily invaded by bacteria, leading to foul smelling discharge. The cholesteatoma matrix also has a destructive properties because of it secretes the enzymes which causes destruction of the local ossicles and other tissue, and it keeps on invading slowly other tissues, leading to a foul smelly discharge. The culprit bacteria is a dreadful bacteria called Pseudomonas aeroginosa, which leads to a green discharge from the ear. So whenever there is a foul smelling ear discharge, we have to do a oral toileting, that is cleaning up of the ear canal, and look for debris such as a cholesterol plaque or a cholesteatoma plaque in the posterior superior quadrant. If there is any perforation or if there is any attic defect, we have to do a thorough examination, sometimes under microscopy or with a otoendoscope. Then we will be able to arrive at a correct diagnosis. We have to take the pus for culture and sensitivity test to see which bacteria is growing. Then if the cholesteatoma is suspected, we have to do other investigations such as a high resolution CT scan of the temporal bone to see where all the cholesteatoma is spreading and what are the tissues which it has destroyed, whether it has destroyed the facial nerve or the lateral semicircular canal, and then we can plan the surgery. Surgery is mandatory whenever cholesteatoma is there. So we do a surgery called mastoidectomy. It's generally a wide open cavity mastoidectomy where we remove all the diseased tissue and lower the facial ridge, making it as a wide cavity so that the self-cleansing mechanism is established and disease does not accumulate inside and grow inwards. Later on, we also reconstruct the hearing mechanism by the tympanoplasty operation.